أعوذ بالله من الشيطان الرجيم، بسم الله الرحمن الرحيم، بسم الله والحمد لله والصلاة والسلام على رسول الله صلى الله عليه وسلم. رب اشرح لي صدري ويسر لي أمري واحلل عقدة من لساني يفقه قولي. أما بعد، So today we'll be reading دروس اللغة العربية lesson 3. We'll start with the vocabulary. In this lesson, we learn the use of the Arabic definite article al, which corresponds to the English the. When the definite article al is prefixed to a noun, naturally the indefinite article nun is dropped. For example, bayt al baytun becomes al baytu, baytun becomes al baytu. So Arabic has 28 letters. Of these, 14 letters are called solar letters, and the other 14 are called lunar letters. In the articulation of the solar letters, the tip or the blade of the tongue is involved, as in ta, na, ra, sa, etc. The tip of the blade of the tongue does not play any part in the articulation of the lunar letters, as in ba, va, ma, ka, etc. When al is prefixed to a noun beginning with a solar letter, the la of al is assimilated to the solar letter. For example, al shams, meaning the sun, is pronounced as ashamsu. Rather than al shams, we'll pronounce it as ashams. So here, the L la of al is assimilated to the next solar letter, which is shams. So hence it becomes ashams. No change takes place in writing though. Ashams. So it is written as alif, lam, sheen, meem, seen. So it's written the same, but the pronunciation is different. The assimilation is indicated by the shadda on the first letter of the noun. So here is the shadda on sheen. Whereas for the lunar letters, no such assimilation takes place with the lunar letters. For example, al-qamar, al-qamaru, the moon. It is pronounced as al-qamaru. It is not pronounced as akkamaru. No, it is pronounced as al-qamaru. Here are some of the examples, some more examples of the assimilation of the lam of the al to the solar letters. For example, al-najmu, the star, becomes an-najmu. It's not pronounced as al-najmu, but it is pronounced as an-najmu. Similarly, al-rajulu, even though it's written as al-rajulu, you'll put a shadda on ra, and then you'll pronounce it as ar-rajulu, the man. Same thing. Al-diku will become ad-diku, the rooster. Al-samaku, the fish, becomes as-samaku. So you can see the table of lunar and solar letters in the page 19 of the Arabic book. Please refer to page 19 of the Arabic book for the table of lunar and solar letters. Note that the A of al is pronounced only when it is not preceded by another word. If it is preceded by a word, it is dropped in pronunciation, though it remains in writing. For example, al-baytu. Here, the A of al-baytu is pronounced, but if it is preceded by wa, meaning and, wa means and in Arabic, the A is dropped and the phrase is pronounced as wal-baytu. It is not pronounced as wa-al-baytu. No, you pronounce it as wal-baytu. So to indicate this omission in pronunciation, now since you're omitting the A from the word, so there's a sign that is placed above the Hamza. The sign is placed above the Hamza. And then so you'll make it as walbaitu. the initial vowel, alif, e or u, a, e or u, which is omitted when preceded by a word, it is known as hamzatul wasl. So this word is known as hamzatul wasl. This vowel, when it is omitted, when preceded by a word, it's called hamzatul wasl. For example, al-babu maftuhun. The door is open. Al-qalamu maksurun. The pen is broken. So we have learned that the tanween is the indefinite article, and it is to be translated as a house. For example, baitun. It is, so the tanween on baitun, on ta, there is a tanween. So it becomes baitun means a house. This does not apply to adjectives like maftuhun. Even though you write al-babu maftuhun, you do not say the door is open. No, you just say maftuhun because it's an adjective. So if you have learned that the tanween is the indefinite article, and it is to be translated as a, but it does not apply to the adjectives like maftuhun, which means open, and maksurun, which means broken. Now let's read the vocabulary. Ghaniyun, rich. Fakirun means poor. Tawilun means tall. Kasirun means short. Baridun means cold. Harun means hot. Jalisun is sitting. Waqifun is standing. Jadidun, new. Qadimun, old. Qareebun, near. Ba'idun, far, far away. Nazifun, nazifun, clean. Wasikun, dirty. Saghirun, small. Kabirun, big. Khafifun, light. Thaqilun, heavy. Alwaraku, paper. Almau is water. Attufahu is apple. Jamilun, beautiful. Addukkanu, shop. Hulun, sweet. Maridun, sick. Now we will go on to the textbook and do the third lesson. Ad-durutha thalith, the third lesson. Baitun, what is baitun? A house. So now it becomes, if you add al to it, it becomes the house. Al-baitu. And then you, the tanween goes away and then it becomes al-baitu. Similarly, kitabun. A book, al-kitabu, the book. Qalamun, a pen, al-qalamu, the pen. Jamalun is a camel, al-jamalu, the camel. Al-qalamu maksurun, the pen is broken. Al-babu maftuhun, the door is open. Here, even though it is, there is tanween, but maksurun and maftuhun are adjectives, and hence, you're not saying, using the word a. You're not saying a open, but we're just saying the door is open. Al-waladu jalisun wal-mudarrisu waqifun. The boy is standing and the boy is sitting, jalisun wal-mudarrisu waqifun. And the man is, and the teacher is standing. So al-waladu jalisun, the boy is sitting, and wal mudarrisu waqifun, and the teacher is standing. Al kitabu jadidun wal qalamu qadimun, the book is new and the pen is old. Al himaru saghirun wal hisanu kabirun, the donkey is small and the horse is big. Al kursiyu maksurun, the chair is broken. Al-mindilu wasikhun, the handkerchief is dirty. Al-mau baridun, the water is cold. Al-Qamaru Jamilun, the moon is beautiful. Al-Baytu Qareebun wal-Masjidu Ba'idun, the house is near and the mosque is far. Al-Hajaru Saqilun wal-Waraqu Khafifun, Al-Hajaru is the stone, Saqilun is heavy, so the stone is heavy. Wal-Waraqu Khafifun, and the paper is light. Al-Labanu Harun, the milk is hot. Al-Qamisu Nazifun, Nazifun, the Al-Qamisu is the shirt, Nazifun is clean, so the shirt is clean. We'll end here, inshallah. We'll continue the next lesson next time. As-salatu was-salamu ala Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam.